We welcome you today, on behalf of our lead servant, Lydia Young, to pause for prayer. Don't forget, you can submit your prayer requests freely, with no strings attached, via our church app, or website, at holyplacechurch.org. Reading in your hearing. Proverbs chapter 3 verses 5 to 6 KJV. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. May the Lord add a blessing to the hearers and doers of his holy word. Father, we acknowledge you in all our ways. Direct our paths according to your will. Only allow the prayers that are prayed for us be according to your will, and not others' personal convictions or desires. Father, fine-tune our mind, heart, ears, and eyes, that we enter not into unnecessary warfare. Father, help us to mind your business, and not be so focused on our own selfish desires, that we get entrapped by the enemy. Bring conviction to the leaders in our churches that have no concern for the things that concern you. Let soul winning and discipleship be our first priority. Let us not heap to ourselves people who have more of a relationship with us than they do with you. Help us to realize that we are accountable for our obedience and our disobedience. Help us to remember that word says obedience is better than sacrifice. Help us not to walk in partial obedience, that is still sin. Help us not to walk around deceiving ourselves or being deceived into thinking we are okay when we are not. Send a repellent between us and those with ulterior motives that will push us out of your perfect will. Stir up the desire in the church leaders everywhere to win souls. Help us to not only to know, but help us to walk in our assignment that you have given to our charge. Father, remove complacency far from us. Help us to reach the people you have called us to, and do not allow us to just try to impress others. Father, help us to know the difference between those that you have assigned work with us in ministry before we allow them enter into ministry. Give us how to equip each leader with the tools that they need to fulfill their kingdom assignment. Give us how to train laborers, as well as how to make effective disciples. Help us not to be an idol to them. Help us to point them to Jesus, that they might have the spiritual relationship that they need. Expose to every pastor every source of witchcraft and manipulation in the church. Let the power of that manipulation and intimidation die by fire in Jesus' name. Put to death our stubborn will and cause us to walk in humility. Father, give pastors to realize that the congregation seeks friendship, but it's their job to feed, lead, protect, and shepherd them. Send leaders from other reformations that can provide the friendship, so that accountability is not overruled by friendship and relationship in our congregations. Shut down every phone conversation, text, and in-person conversation that seeks to gain control. Father, give your leaders to rededicate the houses of worship that you have chosen them to lead. Help them to see the infiltration that the enemy has sent to divide and conquer. Father, even though most leaders are licensed, ordained, consecrated, or affirmed, give them to seriously rededicate the leaders who serve with them back to you. Let it not just be a dedication with lip service, but give them to take us back to fasting and to prayer. Father, when we are not dedicated earnestly to the work of the ministry that you have assigned us to, it shows to the congregation. Help us not walk around trapped in the imagination of our minds, thinking things are one way when they are another in reality. Help them to see that the presentation of what they want others to believe is not what we see. Help us to stop pretending that there is not an elephant in the room, but give us to address each situation head on as it happens. rather than sweeping it under a rug and hoping that no one will say anything. Father, help us to know that every assignment is not given by you, and help us to recognize the bait of the enemy, that we not be distracted in any way. Help us to be careful not to take upon ourselves that which one has not been assigned to us by you. Give us to see things the way that you see them. Give us to handle situations in the way that you would, that we not cause more harm to any situation, bringing unnecessary warfare upon ourselves. Father, fine-tune us, that we not have anything missing, broken, or lacking in our homes, ministries, and workplaces. In Jesus' name, amen. We thank you for taking the time to listen to today's edition of Pause for Prayer, sponsored by the Holy Place Church. Please feel free to submit your prayer requests with no strings attached. Like this page and share with a friend. Also available live on YouTube at Good Tidings Publish. On behalf of our lead servant, Lydia Young, have an awesome day.